that empowered me on any moon's wildest dreams. Because I'm the receiver of all your calls to the dead. When you consult with those whose lives have ended in mystery, you are really enabling me. My powerful network enervates me, such that I need no longer know where my next orgasm is coming from.
Coming from where?
You know, that's a lie.
Probably not.
You were always so well sexed.
Smoking is hot.
Some people torturers mostly deep down long to be nurturers. Desire though they may to be motherly, nature of the nurturing instills joy into their love.
As to the hermaphroditic fate of them and their hermaphroditic husbands and wives,
I suggest we leave that in the lap of the gods.
Stakes are high, and we will not leave until victory is achieved. Until then, I return to my home and my family. Thank you. Goodbye.
Here, wait. We gave up our marriages. Rejected our families just to follow.
Remind me how easily they forget.
How easily you forget.
Don't remind me. He and Euredice never look at one another. Lock eyes, connect.
Well, they can't because they forget.
When will they end their warring and their whoring?
Tomorrow.
So soon.
Will they have to attack something? Shall we intervene?
Yes.
What do you suggest?
To forestall Armageddon? I'll turn them into hermaphrodites.
They already are.
Then let them know it in a big way. Come, Hera. Start my orbit.
Top day with the plebiscite, dear.
Oh, yes, does it show?
Your bones are showing.
Servants, my robe. Where are the servants?
Resting for tomorrow.
Hand me my robe.
Listen to your bones.
I can't hear anything.
I do. They say relax for the night. Join me. Just don't look at me.
Now, how can I join you when you said in this very room just yesterday that you did not wish to be born?
I said that, yes, but now that I'm here, I'm happy I was. Did my reluctance rub off on you?
Perhaps.
Where?
Here. And here. Do you recognize your most tender rubbing?
Yes. Next time, I won't rub as hard.
Oh, next time, rub harder!
All right, Orpheus. But you like it. I mean, being here alive.
Yes, I like it all. I like the variety, the sights, the sounds. I like the concurrent orbits of the stars, planets, and asteroids of you and me, of the common folk of Beotia, and of the family and the castle on the island next to ours. In short, I love to be alive.
Why do you mention them?
The folks across the sea. Well, I'm gearing up for our attack upon them in the morning.
Then it is only a matter of time. Tomorrow, we embark upon Operation Sail and Smash.
But tonight, why worry about the lives of others when we have in this very room you and me by the pool of Salamacus? Is she here?
Yes.
Shh.
Don't wake her. Stay focused, Orpheus. Come. Catch me while I flutter.
Oh. Okay, wait. 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 Stop. Stay still. Okay. Now.
Do you feel it?
Oh, yeah. What is that?
I don't know. Resist it.
Oh, wait, whoa, whoa, wait, stop, ow, stop, stop, back, ow, you're squishing me, I need to step back a step.
I think we both do. You need to be more toned, Orpheus, if you expect to feminize my reflex. And I need to reassess the error of my ways, the mistake of our matrimony, and the mystery of my pubis. What is this?
You're asking me?
Whom shall I ask? Derek? Shall I ask the gods?
Yes, by all means, then you should ask. This weirdness is the work of the gods.
They're on to us.
I thought they were humanists. Aren't humanist atheists?
No one is, when smitten by my smoking thunderbolt.
Damn you, gods! Isn't it past your twilight time?
Oh, why do they say that?
They can see our future. They see how all the gods come together in a single clusterfuck. But until then, let it be this!
Oh, he's vaginating! She's seeping into him!
Oh, Orpheus, stop it! You're liquefying beneath me! Something like quicksand!
He's got to feel that!
Who between them will be the first to reach climax?
Who between them will be the first to reach for the umbilical cord? They're going too far, pull them back!
Oh, no, hold the line, they're nearly done!
She's still grinding into him, you suppose he'll stand for that?
Oh, he's standing now!
It arouses me to see them so evenly matched. Unless, of course, they love each other.
They do. Well, they never look at one another. Oh, lock eyes! Connect!
Eye contact will blow them apart.
Aren't you going to the pond?
Yes. If I'm to be in bed before twilight, I'd better get going. Tell me how it all ends. Goodbye.
I will. Bye.
He finally gone?
Santa, yes, your father. He just went to his bath.
Peace on Earth at a polarizing price.
Oh, I love you, Euredice.
And I appreciate your flexibility. But what made our gender so mutable? You watched others. Is that what softened you?
Yes. Observing couples in the magic pond, I know what happens when people love. And I have been watching the family in the castle on the island next to ours.
Sick man to consider them with the breath that you bait in my presence. Mobilize the Commonwealth. Destroy them or die.
Yes. But during the glow before the dawn, let's survey our troops as they sleep.
Shall we walk among them?
No. Better to gaze from above. I know a secret passage.
Lead the way.
Don't push. Our soldiers sleep in perfect formation.
Let me see.
Oh, wait! Eurydice, stop! About face! This way we can go no further. You'll cast us to our death.
I feel like the back half of a donkey, and it's too tight to turn.
Oh, well, step backwards. Slowly, one foot at a time. Let's stop dissecting the mechanism of our existence. We become irretrievably lost above our heads with no way out. So let's put the fragments back where we found them, to be dislodged again, not in our time, but another time to come. Oh, to see our soldiers sleeping so faithfully doesn't leave me with a good feeling about tomorrow. In fact, I'd call it dread.
Let's soak some more.
Our borrowed time may never seem to end. Although the end is near. The moments that we spend, but battle day is here, and when it's time to go, didn't we know it was only for a while? In time, in tune, we can hold on till the dawn, then swoon here in our pool. Just for a while. So roll apart, let's take the one way home.
love you like a sponge, then love the one you choose. And when it's time to go, what do we know? It was only for a while, in time, in tune. We can hold on till the dawn, then swoon here in our pool.
They're city ducks! Drop the lines!
The chords descend.
What is this interference from above?
Stems?
I recognize them as though from long ago. But where do they go? For some reason, I'm tempted to plug this into you!
You first, my little tomato.
Okay, well then you. For you see how this nub connects to the star-shaped folds of your sherbet-scooped belly button?
Go ahead. Careful. Just don't look at me.
Well, I don't have to. I know how beautiful you are.
I gather my cords. They all attach to me. Coming toward us who are jaded, your brow shady, your eyes. I cannot make out the content of your idyllic eyes. When your eyes on the sparrow, your heads up and stooping, you will conquer your big heart's idea. For a passage through the valley where the predators are real. So today before tomorrow, lift your head up when the sky shows. Then your head up high goes. That great day improves a lot when the sun warms up the misty leaves. Leaves that turn to amber. Rainbow colors reach the spectrum and
whatever. we went away. Tell me if they could talk, if they were here, would they look our way? Is the break something better as we walk through the door? Is the break something better, rising coupled on the floor? Tell me, where do we go? What do we do since we went away?
We received our arm shipment. And we received your payment. Thank you. What about it? The bombs are defective? I'm sorry. Yes, we could have tested them if we were willing to destroy the island.
Who are you talking to?
Our customers on the Isle of Beotia. They said the bombs we sold don't work.
Of course they don't work. They're way too dangerous to fall into the hands of mere mortals.
Well, how'd we get them?
We didn't. Keep your eyes on the road and your hands on the wheel.
They want a refund.
Well, buyer beware. Okay, that's them chasing us from behind, and you're talking to them on the phone? Hang on, step on
it! I'm speeding just as fast as I can!
Go faster, they're gaining! How are we supposed to know the bombs were defective? What a stupid question! They have our trash, we have their treasure. From now on, follow my instructions precisely. At the next curve, cut the headlights. Okay, they're following our cell phones, so throw them off the cliff. Now! Now put them here, and turn off the motor. Coast. All the way down, deep into the hidden valley. Stop! I think we lost them.
I feel more masculine if you let me find my own way.
I feel more feminine if you could.
It's the moon. It's pulling at our polarities, reversing them as if we were stars or planets ever in balance as they realign.
Our bodies also maintain a push and pull orbit. That's because I'm PMSing. Or is it that we're losing our moon? We'll never be worry-free till we're off the island. For now, though, this is as good a hideout as any.
The House of Roadside Psychotherapy? I don't know. I don't think we should risk it.
I hate when you get wishy-washy. Wait in the car. Well, this is right up your alley. They're doing a promotion where they'll pay couples to have sex with their staff. You're into that, aren't you? I told them you were.
Sure, why not? Who works there?
Oh, I have never experienced cramps like today. Everything is clear to me now. It is the moon reversing our polarities. Look, we're losing our moon.
Look closer than the moon. Do you see the smoke from the top of the island where the munitions factory was?
All that nitroglycerin we stored under the
bed. Our cat must have jumped on the bed and set fire to the entire forest.
Well, should we get settled for the night?
Shall we wait? Sounds like they're having a meeting.
You two can make a difference. You can change the world.
Let's join them. They sound pretty welcoming. You don't have to tell them who we are and what we've done.
Okay.
Wait. We have the treasure from our international arms deal, but no local currency. Before we get settled at a House of Roadside Psychotherapy, I think we'd better find some gainful employment. Did you notice on the car chase a help wanted sign at that ale house? It says Tuesday psychic needed.
You're a psychic. Why don't you check it out?
Yeah, wait in the car.
Where did you go? What did you do while you were out?
Got the job.
One day a week?
Yeah, they're covered for the other days.
Was it crowded?
Or on Monday, yeah.
When you were small, when I was tall, we had no doubt.
I'll get us a room.
Or in a summer wind, as seeds took flight within, the finches long, and we may long, till nature lets us join her throng, as petals lift away. Where's our wind to sail today?
We still don't have any money, Clara.
Just hold your head up high. When they asked for a deposit, I told them I'm a visiting psychic at the alehouse, and the money will be coming in soon. Besides, they said they'll pay us to have sex with their staff.
Our four-car garage,
geese and fowl, how high they flocked, as box kites lift away. Where's our wind to sail today? Some written words were meant to be spoken, say them and then the spell will be broken. When the air is still, send them. Arms open, sails out wide. We need the wind to rise. Remember when it did.
And watch it rise again.
Swirling like shrouds, the trees will be veering. Enter the clouds. What I'm hearing, that old black magic has slipped away. Worshipping trees adore my plane.
My new white magic will save the day.
Where did you go? What did you do? While you were out.
Thank you for listening, Dr. Fricasee. Thank you for listening, Dr. Fricasee. I'm concerned about Clara. She's lost all faith in me as a man. It's destroying my spirit. She thinks she's God. She's possessed, Doctor. Somebody seems to possess her.
Possession is 9/10 of the law.
Who among this community is responsible for local possessions?
Most women around here are possessed by men.
Well, she's my girl, Doc. She's always been my girl. What do you say? Shall I call an exorcist?
Do you understand the difference between poly and monotheism? She doesn't claim she's one of a pantheon of gods. She claims she is God. That's like a common foot soldier saying he's Napoleon Bonaparte. Before we awaken and engage the services of an exorcist, we must exhaust all psychiatric remedies.
Well, so it's back to the House of Roadside Psychotherapy.
Just until you can steer yourself clear.
Then can I call an exorcist?
Of course. Now, go back to your girl, young man. Please excuse me.
After a long, hot summer on the battlefields of casualties and conquest, the king and queen of Beotia approach with trepidation the transition from autumn to winter, during which their sexes seem to change.
Seems? I know not seems, nay, we do very visibly exchange plugs for sockets. Sockets for plugs.
And although this transition happens every year, and we're nearing our 10th anniversary, it is still a trauma.
Why didn't you tell me about this before we were married?
It never happened before, but I guess that's what happens when people marry.
Did you see the people moving into the island next to ours?
Yes, I've been watching with increasing trepidation.
Why does their happy enterprise exert such a bizarre fascination on you?
I don't know. But it's exactly the sort of thing I need to engage the common folk. You do know what this means, don't you?
Operation Sail and Smash. We attack at dawn. Our battle with the folks across the sea
started when we noticed they were there.
Didn't we?
just for a while.
This is an action for divorce. For the record, please state your name and application report.
My name, Charlotte Jones Farouk, and I wish to withdraw my application for divorce.
What grounds did you bring your action for divorce?
Abandonment.
And why do you want to withdraw your application, which you granted would sever all ties between you and he?
My husband is dead. He died 2 months ago
of a brain aneurysm in an Egyptian prison where he was serving time for illegal arms sales. He was 49.
Divorce withdrawn, Miss Jones. I mean, Widow Jameson Farouk. The court will take a short recess.
Judge, before you go, my husband had a collection of anatomic and pathological samples in one of his investment properties. I call for the restraint upon the auctioning of that property, Moon Castle, on the island of Xuxu, adjacent to ours. I want to designate that castle a college of physicians under the direction of J. Clarence Fricasee, M.D., a renowned doctor of biology. I want to visit this castle. I intend to make it a resource for anatomy and human medical anomalies. It is my understanding that this property is being auctioned as we speak in the courtroom next to yours, hence the emergency.
Renowned?
Yes. Dr. Fricasee wrote the book on the safe delivery of babies.
I do not know.
You will, when he finds the cure for war.
I'll sign it. Here.
Bring this order with you to the court next door.
I also need the coordinates of the property so that I can direct people to it.
The auctioneer should have all that. I suggest you speak to my son at the ship's dock for a vessel will take you there. Is that all?
Would you care to join us?
No. You won't see me traveling anytime soon. I like it here.
Anyway. Ben. No. Very well. Thank you, Your Honor.
Good day.
Progresses, traditional medicine resists. As evolution moves toward hermaphroditism, more and more doctors confront the appearance at birth of ambiguous genitalia. Here, in the College of Physicians on the island of Xuxu, we will consider the age-old impetus to maintain, for the stability of the body, the two-sex system. In our formaldehyde jars, we see too many examples. Surgical adjustments botched by doctors confounded by ambiguous genitalia. In our effort to cure ourselves of war, we are not eliminating distinctions. Rather, we are discerning, discovering, delineating, making finer, subtler distinctions between individuals in two groups. And if that means giving up one sex for the other, then so be it. Discuss.
I love that in the face of adversity, you betray your own.
I do. I refuse to engage in men's organized sport activities, and they hate me for it. But there's really not that much difference between men and women. Let me show you. Oh, sorry. Really, there's no need to apologize. I've seen this before, the hormones, the nurturing instinct. I was a mama's boy.
I couldn't help myself either. The nurturing instinct was preventing me from fulfilling my purpose in life. I'm a living testament to liberation through releasing my grip on my sexual identity, and by releasing my other grips as well, I'm free. Thank you, Dr. Fricasee.
Now, Charlotte, I don't deserve all the credit. Your grip was always tenuous at best. Didn't you once as well have a grasp or two on reality?
I once had grips and grasps on sanity and reality back when I used to hold on.
Not anymore.
I let go, thanks to you. Shall we shake on it?
Done. Oh, not again. Damn. That's a mighty grip.
That's what my husband used to say through his tears and my vice. Once I squeezed so hard, he said I left him bent.
The medical term for that muscle injury is fractured. He insisted you close your legs while he spread his. Was that it?
How did you know? He actually made me cross my legs as if to nip him in the bud.
He did not hold you precious.
He desanctified our love by making me not precious.
Unlike here, where it is a rare mixture of biology and genuine affection existing now in time between the two of us. I treasure and hold you precious. With my mentoring, you'll find that the penis growing inside of you will be one of great portent.
What do you mean by that, Dr. Fricasee?
I mean that we have both masculine and feminine inside of us.
And we who reside here at Moon Castle change according to the path of the sun god. During tonight's equinox, I'm having my first orgasm of the new season, and I want you to share it.
Let's invite the students to share mine with yours. My position is that men and women each should have the opportunity of having both. These years of black and white polarize the world toward killing and exploitation. Our benefactor and willing subject, Charlotte Jameson, has accepted this cause as her own. As men are being phased out as genetic mutations, we are finding that women are the vessels through which we all must pass. There is no changing childbirth. Many of us have yet to experience these miracles, and I ask cross-genderers to assist us in our studies.
I invite all of you here at the castle to join me in my first orgasm of the season. See you downstairs.
Charlotte, how did your husband acquire this collection of antique formaldehyde jars preserved over the last century?
He traded it for some sort of contraband, I'm sure.
Do you have any idea of the knowledge that is to be gained from these specimens, acquired as they were in ways that are unacceptable today?
The important thing is that they are here at Moon Castle, where they belong.
You know, our medical cadavers help us gain access to what is going on inside of us. So, let's visit our ancestors, shall we? I believe your father is down there.
He was my husband.
Yes, Charlotte, I believe he was. In that case, there were specific instructions left with his estate regarding the fate of his wife. Are you aware of that?
I recall he said he would donate his body to science.
Oh, I'm glad someone heard that because he's ours now. In his instructions, he refers to a journal entry. It was from his wife's diary. You know which entry I mean. A journal entry, Charlotte, and timely as well. Almost as if your husband was listening, granting your wish. Here he is.
And what does this label around his toe mean?
This cadaver includes a jar of giblets, which is on that shelf over there.
Alas, that penis. I knew it, Dr. Fricasee. How enlarged it seems now, soaking in formaldehyde.
The spongy hide is highly absorbent, yet note the shape.
Yes. The bent phenomenon. It was big and bent. That's really all you could say about it. He told me to cross my legs, and then he accused me of fracturing it. What a woman he became. His erections were so painful that he insisted that I, as his wife, as part of my duties, should apply pressure to an imaginary hole underneath. What a deal breaker that was. I was often not up to the task. It would just wobble about like a massive clitoris. Ridiculous, really. Unsatisfactory.
I think the event had something to do with his stress medication. Anyway, there's really no need to rehash the past. No marriage can survive that.
It all would have come out in the divorce. Just another controversy silenced by a brain aneurysm. Maybe it's time I came out and talked about it.
It must have been painful for you both.
Especially to him.
It depends on you too.
Me? I suppose it does. I'm not really sure which way I go or which way I forced him to go when he went into me.
This issue of physical compatibility is not always as extreme as yours. Most people are pretty straight, so minor fluctuations do not affect them. But the bent ones...
Oh, the ones whose tunnels are circuitous.
Oh, we don't know that for sure yet about you, Charlotte, but we'll see. Listen, and we will hear more from the talking bones of our ancestors.
When you consult with those departed in death, you are really enabling me
that, Jameson? The poor man! Thank you! I feel a little more sympathy for him now.
I'll leave you two to get reacquainted.
Some people tortures mostly.
For last night's reading assignment, you were given the challenge posed in the testamentary instructions of Jameson Farouk. Who did the reading? Everyone, good. It was two sentences. But who was able to draw the medical diagrams? Only two of my most promising surgical interns. Fine. As we now know, he was quite explicit in his letter from the grave. In order for her to benefit from his wealth, he instructed his beneficiaries to graft his penis, false problems, onto his wife's clitoris.
And we follow those instructions?
If the wife agrees, which I think she will,
I will do so, willingly.
But we still don't know whether he used the organ for good or for evil, though.
Good point. We'll just have to find out then, won't we?
Oh, the organ is horribly discolored.
That is why we must send good blood to it from afar.
If you expect us to help you do that to her, there's something we need to do to you first.
I'm way ahead of you. Here, Dr. Fricasee, our sketches for vaginating a slit through the base of your prostate.
Good initiative, students. Prepare two tables. After I perform Charlotte's surgery, well, one of you is going to have to perform mine.
The provision ship has landed. Mail call, letter from the island of Media, from Charlotte Jameson.
Look, Charlotte, some light reading in the waiting room.
It's a letter from my son, Bondi. He writes to me every month from school. Leave it on my correspondence pile. Proceed, doctor. Hold the chloroform.
Very well, Charlotte. No chloroform for you. Sutures, please. Another moment, and we're... Done.
Ah, great. Now I need to go somewhere where I can use this thing.
Why not right here on the island of Xuxu?
But with whom? We don't know yet whether my husband used this instrument for good or for evil.
My students are way ahead of you on that one, which is why they will prepare my body for just that purpose. Let me be your odalisk.
Don't be long. I'll be at my desk in the library answering correspondence.
Are you sure you don't want any post-op anesthesia?
No, I'm fine. Dear son, Bondi, things couldn't be better here. Yes, I was able to secure a moon castle with the help of a judge and an auctioneer at Sotheby's. I'm patron to a doctor soon to be known the world over for finding the cure for war. To do so, we must engage in a battle of sorts, a battle of the sexes, so to speak. But of its outcome, I have no doubt we will both prevail, spreading peace and goodwill throughout the earth.
I'm almost healed, Charlotte, except for this gaping open wound.
Yes, yes, I'll be right there, Doctor. Anyway, son, keep up the good work. I look forward to seeing you over the holidays. Your loving... mother.
The Mole King is giving the visiting nurses a tour of the dungeon. We're about to witness the first orgasm of the season.
That was a terrible idea. The Mole Men will eat them.
Well, can we get some air down here?
See the path towards world peace. The Mole Men of Moon Island were always at each other's throats. See how they restrain themselves from dominating one another, seeking only to dominate the weaker sex. We're well on the path to world peace now.
I'm glad you can see it that way, Charlotte. I recognize some of them as my interns.
Perhaps you've achieved a breakthrough, Doctor. All of your interns and nurses are mating.
In a manner of speaking, yes. But through my inquiry into the mystery and banality of hermaphroditism, I discovered that dungeons are a breeding ground for paydunk polyps, which serve a purpose as well, entering wombs, eating children before they can pass through the portals.
The Mole Men train them and charm them, yes?
The snake charmers do, yes, while the nurses break water. We can definitely use some air down there. Break the walls if you have to!
Okay!
Do you mind, Dr. Fricasee, if I ask you a question?
Of course, Charlotte, anything.
So how gay are you, Dr. Fricasee?
I'm bisexual. You are too.
I am not. You're just embarrassed because you're attracted to men. I'm not. I'm fine being a man, being attracted to both men and women. But no, I don't think I believe in bisexuality.
No one is bisexual when smitten by my smoking thundermoat.
I'm in trouble now.
For Jim and Clara, being that you're under siege, your situation's terminal, and you will be overcome, we can appear before you in all our modernity.
You come before us from the future.
Yes, with a waiver from the God of Time. And we know it's coming, Clara.
Peaceable, if occasionally possessed of bloodlust, Orpheus is sleeping heavily until awakened by a revengeful Hera who goads him into rage and carnage.
I've never heard of such a thing.
Here they come.
I think we have weapons of mass destruction in here. I suggest that the war is endable if we relinquish our hold on everything. I also suggest we hide in the dungeon. Oh, be careful of the mole men. They've gone. Oh, look what's down here.
It's a little mole.
Well, this is the Mole King. I'm sure of it.
What? Clara, stop that.
What? You did that.
Just for a second.
We will hold you liable for future damages and intentional infliction of emotional distress to this poor man.
She's possessed, Doctor. Ever since our business failed and we hit at the House of Roadside Psychotherapy, she undermines me. Next, she'll want to go out and join the battle.
Sorry.
Death boat! All died from the invasion! Xuxu is rigged! The island is defective! It is unattackable! Our entire army is being wiped out by its own aggression!
As is my entire student body.
As is the entire population of media.
We have nowhere to go now.
Everyone is gone.
Except for we three couples.
May we join you down here?
We have a waiver from the God of Time.
Yes, come down.
Whew. Safe at last. What's the matter with her?
Sorry.
Doctor, have we exhausted all psychiatric remedies?
Oh, yes. Call an exorcist.
How much does it cost?
Don't ask. We have no money.
How am I going to pay the guy?
God's are taking care of
her. Take a moment to look at her. Maybe she really is God.
She has my vote.
Sorry.
There's been a misunderstanding. I teach my students to become gods. I'm a teacher at the God School, and she is my star pupil. Allow me to demonstrate. Choose! To drive out the male in you, I shall open Pandora's box. I want you all to say, drive out the man in her, she will be pure.
Drive out the man in her, she will be pure.
Thank the gods it's her and not us being purified.
No! No! Oh! Snake again!
Oh! That wasn't so bad.
No! Thank you.
Will you have to do this for yourself the next time that it happens?
I think so. Yes, thank you.
You had a paydunk polyp, eating your children before they could pass through your portal.
Well, now that I know how satisfying it is to do so, next time I'll release it sooner. No more gods for me.
You seem to have something of being your butt. Keep talking and I will smite you.
No more secondary emotions for me.
In matters of love, some things are better off not left to professionals. Send away your good old-fashioned lover boys. Let's evenly matched cure our dysfunction the natural way. In the pool of Selenicus.
Whatever you six are, you sure make three beautiful couples. Here, come stand in front of this fresco from Pompeii.
No, you must wait. It's kind of horrible.
Is that an original?
Of course.
Oh, how much contraband did your husband trade for that?
I can't imagine, and I've always hated it.
This day is for you. You stand in front of this fresco for me. Oh, happy three. For synergy, I now pronounce you husbands and wives.
I suggest we go outside and get some air.
Well, as a matter of fact, we can just go right back to our island. Thank you for opening up a window into your world.
Thank the God of Time. Let's not be strangers. Dr. Fricassee,
Are you able to explain this fresco?
Oh, of course.
But we needn't hear it. Jim and I will be outside.
Yes. Sweet people, our own island in our own time.
And you always know where you can find me.
Must we?
No, I will find you.
Where did he go?
I have him right here. The taste of some old men for both sexes is a consequence of the impotency of their resources. They would rekindle by refinement and monstrosity a spark of the sacred fire which animates youth. Such, we think, was the idea which guided the capricious pencil of the author of this frisk.
Or it was someone he was seeing at the time.
Oh. Yes, that's probably yes. Well, all right. Well, come, Charlotte, let's go outside.
I'm already out here, Dr. Fricasee.
Yeah.